Groundwater is essentially the flow of water through interstitial spaces in the soil, so the spaces between various soil particles. During a flood event, as the river rises, you'll also have the driving head for groundwater. It forces the water from the river into the floodplain soils. And eventually it rises as well. So it rises in response to the river rising. Groundwater is important because it can enter basements. Basements are not impermeable. They're not meant to hold out water. So naturally, groundwater, if it's elevated, it will enter the basement. And that's why sump pumps are extremely important and effective, because they collect that groundwater, preventing it from rising above the floor of the basement. It's also important to have an alternate power source for your sump, because in a flood event, it's very likely that the power will be turned off. A flood barrier will reduce the risk of groundwater flooding in three ways. The barrier will actually help to lower groundwater levels, and this is because part of the barrier will be sunk into the ground, and the groundwater will have a longer path to flow across the barrier. The barrier protects against groundwater flooding also by blocking overland flow. And overland flow seeps into the groundwater, contributing to raising the levels and also extending the propagation of the groundwater. All things considered, this depends on the makeup of the soils and its characteristics. It also depends on the magnitude of the flood event as well as its duration. This will determine how high the groundwater rises during a flood event. For flood mitigation projects, this would be confirmed through the design process. The barrier prevents flooding due to sewer backup. So in many cases, and this was a case in the 2013 flood, the floodwaters make their way through into the sanitary system as well as the storm system. And that quickly overwhelms it and causes it to rise. And the lowest point for it to rise into is people's basement. And in fact, during the flood, the majority of basement flooding was as a result of sewer backup. So that's a flood mechanism that will be prevented from flood barrier on land. During the conceptual design process, we use generalized soil types and layout to estimate what the groundwater response might be. And what we found was that there is a chance for some groundwater flooding, but the benefits of blocking overland flooding far outweigh the residual risks, if you will, from groundwater flooding. So that was enough to understand that there's significant value to the project. During the design process, we'll get a better understanding of the groundwater problem, get more site-specific information and investigation, and reassess those findings. For more information on groundwater, go to calgary.ca/floodinfo and click on the Understand section.